Aloha, I'm your Minivan Dyken MD from Out of the Doldrums. Today, we will be exploring the world of nitric oxide, also known as NO, in the context of aging. If you routinely watch this channel, you will know we absolutely love talking about nitric oxide and its many, many health benefits. If you're new to this channel, welcome to the world of nitric oxide. Today, we're going to focus on nitric oxide's crucial role in the aging process. There was a recently published paper that underscores the significant role nitric oxide has to play in slowing down the aging process. This paper offers some additional insights that can help us redefine our approach to longevity and health span. Nitric oxide is a simple and profound molecule. It consists of one nitrogen and one oxygen atom joined by a double bond. It plays a critical role in almost all of our bodily processes, which makes it vital for health and well-being. Here's a few reasons why nitric oxide is so important and why you should care about maintaining adequate levels in your body. It regulates vasodilation and blood flow. It's critical to maintaining immune function and has antimicrobial properties. It helps with brain function and neurotransmission. It helps your cells communicate with each other. It helps regulate your response to injury and stress. It reduces inflammation. It improves your exercise performance and stamina. It prevents arterial plaques from forming, which can prevent heart attacks and stroke. It prevents erectile dysfunction. And that's not even everything that nitric oxide does. It is a teeny tiny gastrotransmitter, and it works its way into every single nook and cranny of your body. It's been well shown that nitric oxide bioavailability and bioactivity decreases as we age. In other words, the older we get, the less nitric oxide we have. If we're sedentary or inactive as we age, nitric oxide decreases even more rapidly. We know that nitric oxide correlates with overall health and longevity, so if we can maintain high levels in the body, we will likely age more slowly. So let's face the bitter reality. Nitric oxide production declines naturally with age. Starting around the age of 23, nitric oxide production begins to decline. And by the age of 40, our bodies have already lost half of the nitric oxide production we had when we were in our late teens and early 20s. By the age of 65, the body has lost 85% of the nitric oxide production it needs to prevent aging and disease. That's kind of depressing. But fortunately, there are some things we can do about it. According to recent research, there are two main ways that can boost nitric oxide for anti-aging. The first is physical activity, and the second is food. Let's unpack these a little. Physical activity, especially cardiovascular and resistance exercises. Personally, my preferred ways are cycling and weight training. Ideally, recommendations are as follows: 150 minutes of moderate aerobic exercise weekly or 75 minutes of vigorous aerobic exercise weekly, plus weight training 2 times per week. This regimen of physical activity stimulates the production of nitric oxide, thereby enhancing blood flow and reducing the risk of age-related cardiovascular diseases. On a little side note, I've been beta testing this little nitric oxide monitor. You can wear it and measure how much nitric oxide you generate while exercising or doing anything else. If you all are interested in this, let me know in the comments below and we'll do a deep dive review video on it. As I mentioned, the second way to boost nitric oxide levels as we age is diet. The foods we are looking for are foods that are rich in nitrates, antioxidants, and amino acids like L-arginine and L-citrulline, which are precursors for NO synthesis. How can I get more of these in my diet, you might ask? Examples of healthy foods that are rich in nitrates are beets and beet juice, spinach, arugula or rocket, celery, and rhubarb. Foods rich in antioxidants are cacao or dark chocolate, berries, artichokes, spinach, and pecans. Foods rich in L-arginine are pumpkin seeds, soybeans, nuts and seeds, and seaweed. Foods rich in L-citrulline are watermelon, cucumbers, pumpkins and squashes, and a food called bitter melon. Have you ever tried bitter melon? It's a unique one. It grows wild here in Hawaii and people seem to love it. It's truly a unique bitter flavor that's really an acquired taste. Nitric oxide is a crucial molecule for longevity, affecting numerous aging processes. It offers a pathway to new treatments for diseases like heart conditions and brain health issues. Nitric oxide's key role involves regulating cell behavior, reducing oxidative stress, and curbing inflammation. Like I previously mentioned, with aging, our NO levels fall, leading to oxidative stress, which speeds up the aging process by damaging cells and causing inflammation. Nitric oxide counteracts these issues by controlling cellular reactions to stress and aiding in cell repair and defense. It also plays a vital role in maintaining the health of our mitochondria, the energy producers in our cells, which helps to keep our cells energetic and delay aging. Importantly, nitric oxide is essential for cardiovascular health. It keeps blood vessels flexible, preventing arterial hardening and atherosclerosis, which is common with aging. By ensuring smooth blood flow and nutrient delivery, NO supports organ health and longevity. There's this famous pathology textbook called Robin's Pathology. We all study it when we're in medical school, and this is a direct quote from that textbook. Quote, well-vascularized tissues are more resistant to infections and capable of localizing and containing offending agents. By contrast, poorly vascularized tissues are relatively inefficient in responding to inflammatory stimuli. End quote. So, blood supply or vascularization really, really matters. Less blood supply results in more inflammation, which is regarded as a key mechanism of aging. There's lots of new research in this field. In addition to diet and exercise, nitric oxide's therapeutic approaches are on the horizon. NO boosting therapies are looking like they will be an absolute game changer. According to one website, the worldwide market involving NO-based therapies was $70 billion in 2018, and it's projected to rise to $125 billion in 2023 and $195 billion in 2028 as new nitric oxide drugs are introduced into the market. So yeah, future prospects for NO-based therapies are bright and are in the works. In the meantime, we can do our best to increase NO production naturally with the strategies we discuss all the time on this channel. So to wrap it up, this study on nitric oxide provides critical insights into the molecular dynamics of aging. NO emerges not just as a molecule, but as a beacon guiding us towards healthier aging. By understanding and harnessing its power, we open doors to not just adding years to our lives, but more importantly, adding life to our years. Thank you for joining me in exploring the profound role of nitric oxide in aging and longevity. I really hope this video helps you on your individual health journey. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to show us some real support, subscribe. Until next time, cherish your health and aloha.